Ένα γερό χειροκρότημα.
Καλησπέρα. Ευχαριστώ πολύ για την πάσα. Είμαι ο Γιώργος Οτέντες. Και είμαι μηχανικός, λίγο έξω από τα νερά μου σήμερα. Θέλω να σας πω μια ιστορία που μερικές φορές... I have to say it in English. Oh, sorry. Well, that's a fisherman over there. He goes to the lake. He sees dead fish, yellow smoke, yellow water. Okay, he cares, he gets mobilized, he takes a few photos. He shares with his tablet or his iPhone, maybe. Well, there's a climber, he goes to the mountain. He realizes that there's a fire there. Well, he too cares. He gets mobilized, he taps his phone, and he informs other people. Well, they are students. They go to school every day, and they see things. They see yellow smoke, red smoke coming out of factories. Well, they care, and they get mobilized, and they share. All you have to do is share. Well, someone has to take your share, though, and there's an alert. The scientist gets the alert. He also gets mobilized the other way around. He may have to go there. He goes to the lake. He examines the yellow water and the dead fish, and he can share his results. He can go back to his office, assess the data, come to new conclusion, and then he can have the whole picture. And he can share that whole picture through his mobile, through his tablet. Well, it's all you have to do is share, and someone will get the alert. And the alert goes to, well, to the NGOs, the environmentalists. They too care. They are one level above the scientists. They collect information from scientists. They assess the information. They may have even to go there and see the maps, make maps, share with the world, and then comes a chance that they can share the information, they can move it further up the ladder. That's all you have to do, is be the next circle in the chain and share the information, share your photos, share your view of the current state of the environment. And there are also other stakeholders that are interested. They are the hotel owners who have one hotel owner has a hotel by the lake. He doesn't want the fish to be dead. He certainly does not want the water to be yellow. So he has to get mobilized himself. He realizes that his product will be losing value because, as you all know, even the environment has been valued these days. He also gets mobilized, he writes a letter to the press or to other members of his community. He shares the information. The information will move further. And finally, it will get also to the press, because the press observes all messages from the society, from the various levels of society. And then he will go by the lake or by the industry, by the factory. He will have all the information documented in photos or video, maybe an interview with the previous stakeholders. And finally, who gets the information? Well, our friend, the politician. Well, the politician has two options: to ignore the message or to react. In any case, the message has been sent and it's there for everyone to see and know the state of the environment through a map with various colors. Well, with markers on the map, with graphs, with photos, the information will be there for anyone to know. Let's recapitulate. The people share what they see in the environment. The scientists examine the environment and inform other stakeholders. And finally, the politician will do their miracle, hopefully. Well, all this will be done through a mobile application. It's a standard these days. You can do it anytime, but you have to have a special application for the environment because there will be many communities interested. Sorry. We don't have it yet. We don't have it yet because no one has thought of it. Let's ignite it. It's any place. It could happen to anyone. Thank you very much.